this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today I want to talk about the Google Play in-app review API. All right, so over the years, I have spoken many times about the importance of getting app reviews. It's not just important to convince other people to download and use your application. It's also important for the algorithms and your rankings and everything like that. The more reviews you have and the more ratings you have, the better. It gives more proof to Google Play that your app is being used and people like it and all that kind of stuff. Now, historically, it's been difficult to get reviews. I've talked many times before about, I was like, you would like beg and plead to get a review. Like every time I would update an app, I'd say, please leave a review. You'd have the annoying pop-ups that would come up saying, please leave a review. And then you try and, and then you have like a button that's prominently placed to say, please leave a review. Now, usually when you'd have that there, they would click on a button and you would take them back to the Play Store or the App Store, because that was the only way to leave a review back in the old days. It was very difficult to actually do it within the application. And then a few years ago, I think it was with iOS 10, the App Store did start allowing that. So you could have these prompts within the application where they can leave a rating from within your application. You don't have to actually have them leave your application and go someplace else. Well, last month, at the beginning of August, Google Play announced that they have a service that does the same thing. Have a look at this. Now we have the Google Play in-app review API, which allows you to do a very similar thing. Have the little pop-up that comes up here, and people leave a five-star review, and then they could just submit it. So really easy to start building up those numbers, getting those reviews coming in, because like I said, it's really important. Now there's a few things in here. Now I haven't started using this yet, mainly because I wanted to use the iOS side of things, but because I have a lot of cross-platform applications, I haven't yet, but I do plan on start using this because it's, for not just for my own applications, but for all our client applications, because, dude, this is like a missing link. This is like so difficult to get reviews in the past. So here you can see here, we've got the device requirements here, when to request an in-app review. Now, here's a few things that are really important to point out, because I've seen this a lot in the past where they say, hey, especially on the iOS side and on the Android side, people say, do you like the app? And if they say yes, then you send them to get a review. And if they say no, then you're like, oh, okay, well, thanks for letting us know, right? So you only send like the people who like the app to leave a review. Well, here it says, you could trigger an in-app review flow after the user has experienced enough of your app or game to provide useful feedback. That's kind of iffy. But here it says, do not prompt the user excessively for review. This approach helps minimize the frustration limit. And your app should not ask any user questions before or while presenting a rating button or card, including questions about their opinion, such as, do you like the app? Or predictive questions such as, would you rate the app 5 stars? So, for those of you guys who are thinking about doing it, only getting people to rate the application if they really, really like it, you can't do that. At least it's against the terms. I mean, you might be able to get away with it, but I wouldn't try it. Right? Mainly it's about just making it easier for them to actually go in and leave those reviews. Now, so it's available on Android. So now you have the Android side and the iOS side. Now here, if you're a Flutter developer, already these plugins are showing up where you can have the in-app review API here on Flutter. So you could do either the Google Play side way or the iOS way and have everything go in there. And I'm sure a lot of the other cross-platform frameworks will go out there too. Now, reviews seem to be getting a lot more important on the Google Play side of things. I don't know if you guys noticed this also, and I've been trying to like demonstrate this, but we kind of go through and we respond to all reviews anyway, as a matter of course, as we go. But now we've got, if you go through here and leave a review, and here's an application that I got a review here just a few days ago, a 1-star review saying too confusing and too fast. And then I would go through, usually it would be Rowena on my team would go through and respond to it. We have like a bunch of templates and stuff that we use. But now if you click on this, Google Play will actually give you several suggestions on what you could do. So you can say, hi, could you please provide us more, tell us more about your issue? We'd love to understand what went wrong with your game. Hi, may I ask you to please leave a star, email us and we'll improve it. And these kind of stuff, which is really helpful. So it's real, obviously Google Play wants you to leave a review. They want to have a better user experience, and this is going to make things a lot easier for us as developers. Now I've talked before about how to leave a response to review. And as a developer, it can be very easy to get defensive. Too confusing and too fast. as a developer, I could think, what does he mean too confusing, too fast? I could be sarcastic and say, actually, it should be T-O-O and not T-O or whatever. But really, it's, you know, I should be grateful that he's leaving a review. So one of my rules, and one of the rules, you know, within the team has always been, always thank them for the reviews, even the one-star reviews, unless it's something that's really, really nasty. Because, you know, they've made the effort to leave a review. If they don't like it, you just say, hey, thanks for your feedback. Sorry you didn't like it. We're improving this app all the time, and your feedback is invaluable to us, right? It stings sometimes, you know, but it's always important just to let them know. Years ago, I read this book on customer service. I mean, it was like, I was a junior developer. I was doing this customer support role. And I think unlike anybody else who's ever done that role, I went to the library and got a book on customer service. And it was just some dumb book. But one of the things they talked about was how like only like 1 in 10 people who have a bad experience will bother to leave a review. So the fact that, you know, one person leaves a bad review means there's probably at least 10 times that out there who are having those same kind of issues. So it's something that, you know, to take into advisement. But anyway, the purpose of this video is, in case you guys haven't seen it, and I didn't see it, I completely missed it for a month, the Google Play review API is out. So now you can actually prompt people for those reviews, and it should hopefully make the whole thing a lot simpler and easier going forward. So let me know what you guys think. Are you guys interested in this API? Do you think it's gonna help your reviews and everything? And did you know it existed? Because it went completely past me. So anyway, that's it for today. I will talk to you again next time. Okay.